everything we have from Allah's blessing, His treasure. So whatever we have it, take it, use it, utilize it. Ever comes in our life something difficult, something, we don't live in a paradise. This is a dunya. No, everything will happen according to what I seek in my family. No, everything will happen according to you seek in a family. It has to be sometime up and down with the community, society, and humanity. But at the moment where we have a difficulty, try to remember that I have been surrounded by so many bounties and blessings. What about that? Many times we just say, why I had to be tested? Why I have to face that problem? Why this is happening with me? Instead of saying, why? Just see that why I have been blessed by so many things, my respected brothers and sisters. So my respected brother, let's thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for every bounties and blessing we have. We come to pray Jummah Salah, subhanallah. Did we understood? This is also a blessing of Allah that I'm able to come, take our time off from the work, or schedule our work, whether it's a job, whether it's a business. And then subhanallah, some of the brother comes an hour before. And mashallah, the read surah kaf, engage in tasbihah. Did we ever understood? This is also, it's because I have been chosen. He's the one who's guiding. Who's giving me ability? While we know that good percentage of our community, they don't even go to jail. They don't. Not talking about the child, innocent, the minors, or a smaller, a certain grade. I'm talking about the adults, my respected. So anything we have is a blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And understanding that, that what I have is a blessing, that is also a blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then if you understand that, things will be easier in our life, we'll be gaining something greater in our life, and the life will be getting fantastic, fabulous, more joy and happiness, because this is what Allah wants. Allah wants His slave to feel it, that he is slave, and Allah wants us to understand that he is a master. Allah does not like from the slave that he act like a master and just believe he is a master. That's why Allah says in Hadith al-Qudusi, Al-Kibriya'u Ridai. When the person says, do you know that who you're talking to? Very commonly, person attitude change very quickly. Person, we do respect sometimes, we dress nice, our way of walking change. Sometimes we buy, have a good car, our way of driving change. Sometimes we get into the certain level of a house, the person meeting and greeting change. Knowledge, position, ability, quality, whatever person is has been associated with, that should not, because end of the day we are the human being. That's why Ali radiallahu ta'ala says, when the person change based on the situation and scenario, it's not he changed. He was hiding who he was throughout the whole time. He was just waiting for the right time to expose the reality of it. So Allah wants from us, as we are in Riyah, we are the slave and a servant, and He's our master. When we have the mentality, my respected brother, for small thing we'll be thankful what we have. For small thing we'll be patient when we face any trial and a test. And then, my respected brother, this will be the key to achieve greater and greater and greater. And then, subhanAllah, our life, you will just notice that you're just smiling. Remaining tension-free, relax. When you're sitting with your wife, it's a joyful moment. When you're sitting with your children, joy. When you go outside, it's a life, it's a joyful. Because you think that whatever is happening, there is a khair. There is a khair, inshallah.